Hey. How's it going? Gosh, it's been a long prep, I'll say that. But it's been an amazing one. I did something completely different that I haven't done in the past. I had decided to go vegan, and just a personal decision for my health. And then a few weeks later, decided on a show. And so I did my first vegan prep ever. And I've done three shows back to back. My first show being the John Sherman Classic on October 14th. And then I went off to Oklahoma, October 28th. Won first there, so that qualified me for nationals. So I'm here. But it has been amazing. Probably the best prep I've ever had, ever. The most enjoyable. I feel alive, lots of energy. I mean, that's been the biggest thing. And on top of all that, I've looked my best. And at every show, I improved. Like, I brought my best look ever to the first one, then it got better at Oklahoma, and then it got better for this. So, like, I can't, to end my season here looking my best and feeling my best, it's amazing. It's awesome. It's truly thankful. Awesome year.
Talk about how big this show is.
This show is massive. I knew it was going to be big. I mean, it's like the pinnacle show of the year, right? I mean, it's the last national. Everyone that's qualified is showing up pretty much. And, you know, I already expected the bikini class to be probably as big as a local show, right? So when they told us how many girls there were, I was like, oh my God. Because it's just under 300. And in my class alone, there are 50 of us. So it was class C. We were the biggest class. And I think every class was probably around 40 to 50 of us at least. So insane. But it's awesome because you make so many new friends, people that, you know, are like-minded, obviously. We all love this sport. We love, you know, just health and fitness. And it's just been great. And you walk around the hotel and there's nothing but fit people everywhere. You know, whether they're competing or not, it's just super fit people. And then seeing some of your idols, I'm like starstruck. I'm like, oh my God, there's Charles Glass or there's Jay Cutler. Like, you know, it's crazy. It's awesome. It's been amazing.
Have you gotten to talk to anyone here about the vegan lifestyle?
I haven't met any other vegans, to be quite honest. And no one's kind of really asked, like, about my prep or what I'm doing. I haven't had those kind of convos with anybody yet. But, I really actually have not run across any vegans. If they're here, they're hiding out or something. So, yeah.
Some motivation. I've asked you this before, I think, but people who are struggling with fitness and eating clean, what would you say to them?
Oh, it is, of course it's a struggle. It's hard. I mean, there's temptation around you all the time, whether it's, you know, the marketing itself for food, right? Like, it's enticing. Or your friends that are just like, just one bite isn't going to kill you, this and that. And sometimes that can automatically cause a downward spiral. But I would say that what you have to remember is, when you have a goal, there's always going to be obstacles, no matter what. And they're going to come at you in ways that either you expect, and you're like, oh, okay. Or they're going to be in ways that you don't expect. And you're just like, oh my God, I don't know what to do in this situation. Whether it's I'm, you know, out here and there's nothing healthy for me to eat. How do I make the right decisions? Things like that. Those obstacles are going to happen. But when you know what your end goal is, you will always find a way. Like, if you're really focused on the end goal, you will find a way to achieve it if you really want it. If you don't really, really want it and it's not in your heart, then it's easy to just give up and just lose focus. And you have to be consistent. You have to. It all boils down to consistency, of course, and just being determined. That's all I can say. Just never giving up. Yeah, it was very strange. I don't know if that's, I don't know why that is. Like, just maybe not knowing what to expect, so just kind of going with the flow type of thing. I didn't even, and I thought, well, I'm going to get nervous, you know, standing in line. And I didn't, because I don't, I was talking to everyone around me and just, you know, hearing everyone else's like journey through their prep and stuff. Like, it was just very, just been an enjoyable experience. And I think even if I had super, super high expectations for myself, I don't know if I'd be that nervous. It's just been so incredible just to be here and just to be around people that, you know, have qualified like you. I mean, it's an honor to be here and step on this stage. So regardless of your placing, gosh, you should hold your head high and be proud. And when you walk out, you're just beaming. I mean, not everyone gets to step on this stage. So no nerves. I don't know what's wrong with me. So
is it hard doing a 2-day show?
It was a different challenge for sure. Especially, I've done a 2-day show before, but it's been a very long time. So it really boils down to, it was hard trying to figure out when we're going to be on stage. So timing my meals yesterday was a little bit of a challenge. So I started eating too early, I think. I should have waited a little bit longer. So today, I'm about to eat my first meal and be done probably around like 9 or 10 with my last meal, just in case we're still on stage. I still have enough fuel and energy to carry me through. So that was one thing. The second thing, of course, is holding that look for 2 days. You know, even if you don't get first call outs, you still want to make sure that you look the same as you did day one, or maybe better. You know, if you refuel and rehydrate a little bit the night of day one, you could look a little bit better day two. But yeah, holding that look for 2 days is the most important part for sure, for sure. I think I'll time it better today, absolutely, and feel a lot better. I was definitely shot after yesterday, having started eating too early and then having my food every 3 hours, so.
Just two more questions. Anyone you want to thank for this prep? How many are you
on? There are so many people that I want to thank. First and foremost is my nutritionist and coach, Kim Porterfield. She started with me when I was 21 years old. And, you know, for a while when I went through my challenges and things like that, which, you know, I've spoken of before, and went through depression and stuff, and I stopped competing, you know, and then I came back and I did it myself. And I was like, you know, I really want to go to the next level. Will you work with me again? And here we are, you know, and here I am at my first national show ever. And I mean, that woman knows almost everything about me and my health and my story and just journey itself. So she's my rock with all of this. I would say that next would be Stephen Ray, who's helped me a lot with my workouts. During the off season in particular, I really wanted to grow and build up my legs and, of course, my glute and hamstring tie-in, because I'm a bikini competitor. That's what we do, right? So really just taking my workouts to another level, and he really helped me with that a lot. And honestly, my friends and family, you know, I have two friends in my life that literally know what I go through every single day. And, you know, one of my best friend and then my roommate, and just my family for being supportive. And I don't get to see them all the time. And I'm really, really looking forward to that. I can't wait for quality time with my friends and family, you know, during the off season and stuff. But to have people around you that understand your passion and how much you love this, and they're okay with, I know I can't see you tonight or this weekend because you're in the gym, you know, or whatever you're doing, it's amazing. I mean, I wouldn't be where I am with my support group at all.
Just last question, are you doing anything fun for the holidays?
Nothing too crazy and exciting, just family time. That's what I'm looking forward to the most. Like Thanksgiving, I'm gonna, you know, get to see my brother, meet my brand new nephew, and see my other little nephew that I absolutely adore. So I'm just really excited for that. Absolutely. Just downtime, and I guess I'll be training, of course, because season will start soon enough next year. But yeah, just that quality time. So.
Thank you.
Yay!